If you want to explore this issue further, visit Hassle Inclusion's website, who are the UK's leading experts on digital accessibility. They can carry out an audit of how accessible your digital products are, provide training for your software developers, designers, or product managers, and look at the governance of accessibility in your organisation. The dark side of technology. Not all technology is helpful for diversity and inclusion. There have been news stories over the last few years about robots and artificial intelligence behaving badly and causing havoc in an organisation. Amazon found themselves in a difficult position when they discovered that their recruitment process had become sexist by screening out potential female candidates. Investigation revealed that the artificial intelligence software used in the selection process had been created by an all-male team and had adopted their biases. A report by James Cook, published in 2019 in The Telegraph, revealed a racist passport photo system. It had rejected the image of a young black man despite its meeting government standards. This was embarrassing for the UK government, who had not tested the software thoroughly. The software thought that the applicant had his mouth open in the photo. On the feedback form, the applicant wrote, "My mouth is closed. I just have big lips." The press picked up the story after he posted it online. When creating software, we must be conscious of any bias that might go into its development. However, I am a lot more hopeful about the opportunities that software does offer for organisations to scale up their diversity and inclusion. The future for digital services. Digital services are constantly improving. The future is full of opportunities for organisations to consider how they can take advantage of them to improve diversity and inclusion,